Hello everyone, and welcome back to Skyrim. So I was doing some thinking, and I definitely need to get better spells, specifically like a better basic destruction spell than just my dual flames. So I think I am going to go back to Whiterun after all, and turn in the Dragonstone Tablet, make up some story about, we got sidetracked or something, in case they ask, which they're not going to, because, well, the game doesn't really track you like that. But anyway, we're going to go back to Dragon's Reach. Turn in the Dragon Tablet. Talk to Farangar. See if he has some more spells we can buy. And, well, you know what's gonna happen.
Well met, kinsman.
Hey, look at that, Bob's back. Hello, Bob.
Heard they're reforming the Dawn Guard.
They need, like, better security or something. Oh, I guess they made Bob stay outside. That makes sense. Farangar, are you in here?
You see?
Oh.
The terminology is clearly First Era or even earlier. I'm convinced this is a copy of a much older text. Perhaps dating to just after the Dragon War. If so, I could use this to cross-reference the names with other later texts.
Good. I'm glad you're making progress. My employers are anxious to have some tangible answers.
Oh, have no fear. The Jarl himself has finally taken an interest, so I'm now able to devote most of my time to this research.
Time is running, Farangar, don't forget. This isn't some theoretical question. Dragons have come back.
Yes, don't worry. Although the chance to see a living dragon up close would be tremendously valuable. Now, let me show you something else I found. Very intriguing. I think your employers may be interested as well. Hmm? Bah, yes, the Jarl.
Yes, oh, hey! Hello.
Back from Bleak Falls Barrow. You didn't die, it seems. Ah, the Dragon Stone of Bleak Falls Barrow. Seems you are a cut above the usual brutes the Jarl sends my way.
And so what about my reward?
You'll have to see the Jarl about that. Maybe his steward, Avenici. I'm sure one of them will pay you appropriately. My associate here will be pleased to see your handiwork. She discovered its location by means she has so far declined to share with me. So your information was correct after all. And we have our friend here to thank for recovering it for us.
You went into Bleak Falls Barrow and got that? Nice work. Just send me a copy when you've deciphered it.
Well, thank you.
Farangar, you need to come at once.
Oh, man, I'm not used to your hair.
You should come too.
A dragon? How exciting.
Wait, what?
Where was it seen? What was it doing?
I'd take this a bit more seriously if I were you. If a dragon decides to attack Whiterun, I don't know if we can stop it.
I was kind of hoping to talk to Farangar for a little bit. But,
Let's go.
So, Irileth tells me you came from the Western Watchtower?
Yes, my lord.
Tell him what you told me about the dragon.
Oh, that's right.
We saw oh, that's right.
It was fast.
I forgot.
Faster than anything I've ever seen.
What did it do? Is it attacking the Watchtower?
No, my lord. It was just circling overhead when I left. I never ran so fast in my life. I thought it would have come after me, for sure.
Good work, son. We'll take it from here. Head down to the barracks for some food and rest. You've earned it. Irileth, you'd better gather some guardsmen and get down there.
I've already ordered my men to muster near the main gate.
Good. Don't fail me. There's no time to stand on ceremony, my friend.
Okay.
I need your help again. I want you to go with Irileth and help her fight this dragon. You survived Helgen, so you have more experience with dragons than anyone else here.
I mean, I've seen one.
I haven't forgotten the service you did for me in retrieving the Dragonstone for Farangar. As a token of my esteem, I have instructed Avenici that you are now permitted to purchase property in the city. And please, accept this gift from my personal armory.
I should come along. I would very much like to see
Hide boots of Dwindling Frost.
No. I can't afford to risk both of you. I need you here working on ways to defend the city against these dragons.
As you command.
One last thing, Irelith. This isn't a death or glory mission. I need to know what we're dealing with.
Don't worry, my lord. I'm the very soul of caution.
So it takes. It looks like we've been kind of just mustered up to fight off a dragon. Sure. Let's do this. What could possibly go wrong?
I give you the chance to see this dragon up close.
I think I do want to talk to Farngar real fast.
Come to Dragon's Reach to discuss the ongoing hostilities.
Have any spells that could possibly help me with these ancient beings known as dragons?
Take a look.
Okay. Let's see here. Arrow to the knee. No. Bound sword. I'm assuming that's better than my axe. That's probably better than the sword. But I don't go into melee that much, so... What else do you have? Summon Draugr Warrior? Spirit Cat? Conjure Zombie? Sure, let's summon a Draugr Warrior. Zombie seems kind of up our alley. Kind of curious as to why Farangar has these books, but you know, we won't ask questions. Desperate Invocation that does 6 magic damage, increased by 25% of your destruction. No. Cast Lightning from Your Eyes, hitting for 10 shock damage at a rapid rate until you look away from the target. What? Lightning from my eyes. Huh, maybe I'll grab that. Fiery Touch. A fire-based touch spell that hits the target for 64 points of damage. Only works in melee combat range. The basic Fire Bolt. Flames. 9 frost damage for 3 seconds. When hit by other frost spells, the target is stunned. Gate. Summons the target in front of you. Does not work on flying targets. Okay. I'm assuming. Okay, so that pulls whoever you're looking at towards you, I guess. Silently places a mark of death on a target. After 8 seconds, the mark deals 3 poison damage per destruction skill level. The caster needs to remain undetected. Oh, that's interesting. Inferno. You spit multiple fire bolts, each doing 13 damage. That's kind of cool. Lightning bolts. Mark of Decay. Target living humanoid takes 3 points of disease damage per second for 15 seconds. If the target dies while under this effect, it is revived as a Draugr under the caster's control. That's up my alley. Remembers your next spell and has a 50% chance of reproducing it each time you cast another spell. Interesting. Phantom Image, Phantom Pain, Power of the Master. Command nearby minions to unleash a lightning blast, doing 21 points of shock damage to targets around them. Really? That sounds kind of cool too. The damage is kind of low, 21, but if it's all minions... Ripped Weapons. When active, attacks with bound weapons reduce fire, frost, and shock resistance. Man, there's a lot of cool shit here. Now I'm really only looking over the conjuration and destruction stuff. No. Soul Trap, yeah. Stone Flesh. Yeah, let's upgrade to Stone Flesh. The enemy who sets it off is summoned in front of you. No. Unsummon. Wither. We only have 450 gold left. There was one spell I wanted to try. Inferno, but that's too expensive. Do I have anything I can barter with? Meaning, sell. There we go. Could sell that. That's all I really have. I think that's enough, though. Oh, shoot. Now we gotta go back down. I could always just grab basic firebolt. But that's not what I was looking at, right? Was it Inferno? I think that was it. Oh, and that too. That's pretty cool. Oh, man, there's so much cool shit. But let's go to Inferno. All right. Thank you, Farangar.
If you've got the aptitude,
I know. College of Winterhold. Got it. Thanks. God, he just never shuts up about Winterhold. So many cool spells. So many more than one. Bob, dude, you wouldn't believe it. Where's your eyes? There they are. All right. Took him a second to turn on. All right. Draugr Warrior, Zombie Inferno, Mark of Decay, and Stone Flesh. Jeez, so much new shit. All right, so take that off. Take that off. Call Nadina? Oh, I didn't even realize there was a spell for that. Skeletal Mage is so cool. All right, the damn corpse explosion. Discharge staff. Discharge or suppress an equipped charged staff, converting it to a defensive staff. Interesting. Oh, okay, yeah, here's that illuminated staff stuff. Okay, cool. I guess we should do that. Inferno. Forget about the flames. Well, I guess I can keep it favorited in case. Mark of Decay. Screw Oak Flesh, we have Stone Flesh. Skeletal Warrior. God, we have so much stuff. Okay, so I need to redo my presets here. So, on F2 we have the Armored Warrior and... or Mage. I think I need to do the Stone Flesh now. So, there we go. And then F1... I think we should have Detonate Dead. And... Inferno. Well, no. What else would make sense? Because I can eventually, like, double cast Inferno, so... Mark of Decay? Alright, so let's... Forget Fear. And Bound Dagger. There we go. Alright. So, we have to meet up with Irelith and go hunt down this dragon, apparently.
And deserve our praise you do, for we are one. Ere you
let us say a quick prayer to Talos.
You walked among us straight
down. Asking for his protection in the upcoming fight against a mythical beast, or what I thought was a mythical beast. Well, what Gershner thought was a mythical beast. Although, I guess he did see one of them already.
Yes?
Need something?
Kinda sucks you have to wait for Irelith and her little party to get down the road. That's gonna take a little while.
Need something.
But, here we go.
Here's the situation. A dragon is attacking the Western Watchtower.
Dragon? Now we're in for it.
You heard right. I said a dragon. I don't care where it came from or who sent it. What I do know is that it's made the mistake of attacking Whiterun.
Titans. How could we fight a dragon?
Need something?
That's a fair
need
question.
Something?
None of us have ever seen it.
Well, hello.
Okay, people.
Face one in battle. But we are honor-bound to fight it, even if we fail. This dragon is threatening our homes, our families. Could you call yourselves Nords if you ran from this monster? Are you going to let me face this thing alone?
No.
So I mean, maybe.
More than our honor at stake here. Think of it. The first dragon seen in Skyrim since the last age.
City food isn't the same.
Glory
too much dressing.
It is ours.
Sauces.
If
spices,
you're with me.
Doesn't taste like meat anymore.
Now what
Brock.
Do you say? Shall we go kill us a dragon?
Yeah.
Damn.
Yeah,
let's.
Let's move out.
Let's do this. How am I supposed to explain Bob? If I could at least get Bob some clothing, I could just say he's a very, like, anorexic warrior.
Need something?
Alright. So, I'm not going to be summoning any undead things in this fight, because that would tip these people off that I'm a necromancer. I'm just trying to ignore Bob's presence, because I don't think I can get rid of Bob. Like, I can't ask him to just, like, stand still. I can't dismiss him. I don't think. Right? Well, there we go. He decided to take a vacation inside Whiterun, so I guess that's that. So without doing any undead type stuff, that leaves me with the Inferno spell, which I actually forgot to put on 2. I want to put that on 4. Let's take a quick look here. Reanimation is 3, Conjure is 2. Let's do... I didn't even do Draugr Warrior. I don't want to do this. Let's actually put Inferno as 1, Mage 2, Draugr Warrior 3, Zombies 4, and Detonate Dead is one of these now, right? Yes, it's on 1. Okay. So it looks like I'm going to be doing a lot of Inferno stuff. Can't do any of my summons, because these guards may turn around and kill me. Role-playing, of course. Obviously, the guards wouldn't react one way or another if I was summoning skeletons and stuff. Summoning Bob's little brother.
I wish I could say that I did not, but in every part of Skyrim, there's
no one like... Come on, Aerith. You guys coming faster than that. This is a dragon. Ooh. I'll catch up to you guys. I'm just picking flowers for my alchemy. Again, I've like rarely done alchemy. I have no idea if these flowers are even something I want. Oh, there's the watch, and there's fire. Ooh. Butterfly. I'm not gonna go in by myself. There you go.
Stinks in here. How can people live in these moldering old forts? Look at all this rotting moss.
But it sure looks like he's been here. I know it looks bad, but we've got to figure out what happened. And if that dragon is still skulking around somewhere. Spread out and look for survivors. We need to know what we're dealing with.
Every time I've done this, it's typically like in the rain and at night. I don't know if I've ever done this encounter in the middle of the day before. Huh. I probably have. Just don't remember.
No, get back. It's still here somewhere. Crocky and Tor just got grabbed when they tried to make a run for it.
Guardsman, what happened here?
The heck, he has a
staff. Where is this dragon? Quickly now!
I don't know. Kinnereth, save us. Here he comes again.
Here he comes. Find cover and make every arrow count.
Aha, there he is. All right, dragon. Let me test my powers against you. Oh, boy. Oh, that's pretty cool. Bring him down. Wow, that is really cool. Oh my goodness. Brock, you gotta shoot your arrows at him, man. Oh. Oh wow, they killed him. Nice job, everybody. Hell, oh, rain of fire. Yeah, this Inferno spell, that's kind of... Ho ho. And it begins. Use the shout section of your magic menu to equip your unrelenting force. Yep. So now,
believe it. You're Dragonborn.
Dragonborn. What do you mean?
In the very oldest tales, back from when there were still dragons in Skyrim, the Dragonborn would slay dragons and steal their power. That's what you did, isn't it? Absorb the dragon's power.
I think you may be right.
There's only one way to find out. Try to shout. According to the old legends, only the Dragonborn can shout without training, the way the dragons do.
Dragonborn? What are you talking about?
Oops.
That's right. My grandfather used to tell stories about the Dragonborn.
Someone's talking in the tower. Okay, let me equip this shout.
Foosh! Why will I hold sacred? That's a shout. I've never heard of Tiber Septim killing any dragons.
There weren't any dragons then, idiot.
Idiot.
Not just coming back now for the first time in forever.
Forever. I like that line. Anyway. So as my character,
yeah.
This is pretty good news for us, because we want to push out the Imperials, and now, oh, what the hell? I didn't know you cast magic.
Some of you would be better off keeping quiet than flapping your gums on matters you don't know anything about. Here's a dead dragon, and that's something I definitely understand. Now we know we can kill them. But I don't need some mythical dragonborn. Someone who can put down a dragon is more than enough for me.
You wouldn't understand, House Khan. You ain't an orc.
I've been all across Tamriel. I've seen plenty of things just as outlandish as this. I'd advise you all to trust in the strength of your sword on over
tales and legends. And then random people.
That was shouting. What you just did must be. You really are dragonborn.
So if I can use these, you know, powers of the dragon, which makes sense since my character's gone across these walls with, you know, dragon head fixtures and dragon language, then I think he would be like, yeah, I'm the Dragonborn. And with the Dragonborn powers, I can use them to fight off the Imperials and the Thalmor, and maybe combat these dragons, though that was not Gerstner's original intent. I think it would be a good time to take some of these dragon bones for study. And that probably belongs to one of the guards he ate. Or it ate. So with this knowledge in hand, what would we do? Well, probably would try to test out the other abilities that we've learned so far. Although I only have one Dragon Soul, so unfortunately we cannot unlock these other ones. But I will try to use these shouts more often. It would make sense, I guess, for this character to try and shout, use the power of the Dragonborn. So what do we do now? To go back to the Jarl? What do you guys think? Nah, you guys don't think you don't do anything. I have to do all the thinking around here. Yeah, we should probably go at least grab Bob. Alright, we can't fast travel to Dragonreach. Alright. Let's fast travel back to Whiterun. Pick up Bob. Talk to the Jarl about this, maybe Farangar. And of course here the Greybeard shout for us.
Yeah.
Where is it?
We're causing no trouble.
I mean, there's Bob, but where's that? There it is. Yep. Alright, so let's go to the Jarl and get this sequence done.
Those green apples you sold me the other day were delicious. Need something?
Then where am I going to go after this? I don't think I'm going to immediately go to the Greybeards. I don't think I'll do that. I don't know. Probably try to continue just exploring dungeons and finding what ruins I can as a character to see if I can unlock even more of these dragon powers to combat against the Imperials. I think that's what Gerstner would do. Though talking to the Greybeards would get a more understanding. I don't know.
You heard the summons.
Maybe we will go to the Greybeards.
What else could it mean? The Greybeards.
I mean, what? The Greybeards? Who are they?
About you. My brother needs a word with you.
So what happened at the watchtower? Was the dragon there?
Whew. The watchtower was destroyed, but we did kill the dragon.
I knew I could count on Irelef, but there must be more to it than that.
When the dragon died, I absorbed some of its power.
So it's true. The Greybeards really were summoning you.
Who are the Greybeards?
Masters of the Way of the Voice. They live in seclusion, high on the slopes of the Throat of the World.
Ah, we're going to have to run up there. And what would these Greybeards want with me?
The Dragonborn is said to be uniquely gifted in the voice. The ability to focus your vital essence into a thoom or shout. If you really are Dragonborn, they can teach you how to use your gift.
Didn't you hear the thundering sound as you returned to Whiterun? That was the voice of the Greybeards, summoning you to High Hrothgar. This hasn't happened in centuries, at least. Not since Tiber Septim himself was summoned when he was still Talos of Atmora.
Rungar, calm yourself. What does any of this Nord nonsense have to do with our friend here?
I love this.
Capable as he may be, I don't see any signs of him being this, what, Dragonborn.
Nord nonsense? Why, you puffed up ignorant.
No,
these
nonsense.
Are our sacred traditions that go back to the founding of the First Empire.
Hrongar, don't be so hard on Avenichi.
I meant no disrespect, of course.
Of course.
It's just that, what do these Greybeards want with him?
That's the Greybeards' business, not ours. Whatever happened when you killed that dragon, it revealed something in you, and the Greybeards heard it. If they think you're Dragonborn, who are we to argue? You'd better get up to High Hrothgar immediately. There is no refusing the summons of the Greybeards. It's a tremendous honor. I envy you, you know? To climb the 7,000 steps again. I made the pilgrimage once. Did you know that?
No.
High Hrothgar is a very peaceful place. Very disconnected from the troubles of this world. I wonder that the Greybeards even notice what's going on down here. They haven't seemed to care before. No matter. Go to High Hrothgar. Learn what the Greybeards can teach you. You've done a great service for me and my city, Dragonborn. By my right as Jarl, I name you Thane of Whiterun. It's the greatest honor that's within my power to grant. I assign you Lydia as a personal housecarl, and this weapon from my armory to serve as your badge of office. I'll also notify my guards of your new title. Wouldn't want them to think you're part of the common rabble, now would we? We are honored to have you as Thane of our city, Dragonborn. Back to business, Proventus.
The honor would be mine.
To defend.
Yes, my lord.
Well, that was definitely unexpected, speaking as a character. Coming in here to turn in a dragon tablet just to pick up some spells, and we leave as a Thane of Whiterun. Oh, I hate these kids. Oh, I hate all of these kids.
You're a spoiled baby.
Oh, whoa.
Has appointed me to be your house, Carl. It's an honor to serve you.
So what does it mean to be Thane?
The Jarl has recognized you as a person of great importance in the Hold. A hero. The title of Thane is an honor, a gift for your service. Guards will know to look the other way if you tell them who you are.
And what does the housecarl do?
As my Thane, I'm sworn to your service. I'll guard you and all you own with my life.
I'm sworn to carry your burdens. As a character, I don't know if I would really want Lydia around. Because, I mean, she reports to the Jarl. I mean, yes, she's my housecarl, but still, she's a soldier of Whiterun. Whiterun. And with her around, I would be kind of hesitant to do any of my darker things. meaning summoning skeletons and summoning skeletons and such. So, I mean, I could have her follow me and then have her protect my outpost in the mines, but that doesn't really make sense as a character either, because that's my research lab. So I'm gonna leave you here, Lydia. Thank you for the
until next time.
Thank you for your time, but your services are not needed right now. Yeah, I think I will go up to the Greybeards. I think it would make sense because Gerstner would like want to try and find out more information about this, you know, these dragon shouts. To fight against the Imperials as soon as possible, and if these Greybeards summon me and they obviously know a thing or two about Dragon Shouts, then it would make sense to go up there. So I think that's what we'll do in the next episode, continue on with the main storyline and do that part. Bob, why are you in, like, stop motion? Oh man, last time that happened here, this game crashed. So, you know what? I'm gonna end the episode here, save and quit before my game crashes. So thanks for watching, everybody. Next time we will go to the Greybeards. I'll save you the journey up the 7,000 steps because it's some of the, like, one of the most boring parts in this entire game. And the only time I actually want a horse is to go up those steps. Oh, I hate it. It's just so boring. You fight like two trolls, a bear, and you just gotta climb up the mountain. So we'll probably start when I'm inside the Greybeards temple thing. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Take care.